is Syed Zeeshan. I'm a professional animator, a VFX artist, a filmmaker, and an entrepreneur. So to talk about myself, I started my journey just as you, as a student. I passed out from my college in the year 2015, after which I immediately began my animation career. And I was working as an employee for quite a while. The last job that I was working for was a French agency as a lead animator, where I used to handle both 3D and 2D animation. And not just animation, but dancing has also been my core interest. And I have been a top 5 contestant of a television show on Zee Network. And I'm also a professional choreographer. And I have choreographed for movies here in Kannada industry. And which was one of the main reasons how I could get my client base, you know, how I could transfer my clients from film industry to my studio. And that was also dancing was also one of the main reasons how I got this idea of starting my own company. And at a very young age, I started exploring a lot in the animation industry, and I was exploring a lot in filmmaking. I used to make a lot of films. I used to make a lot of animation shots, which started giving me an idea of this entire process. And you know, it gave me more confidence. It gave me more belief of starting my own company. And it was time, last year that, I decided that, it was time that I start my own company. The company's name is Animotion Studios. So talking about the motivation and inspiration that drove me to be an entrepreneur is, I belong to a family who are, entrepreneurs. And, of course, they're not into the same animation field, but they are entrepreneurs. And I always wanted to be an entrepreneur, but I would say that, it's not at all a good idea to begin your career with an entrepreneurship. It's never a good idea to do that, because you need a lot of experience. You need to have an idea of what, this entrepreneurship is all about. And it needs a lot of homework. So I initially, when I started my career, I had a clear idea that what I wanted to be, but I never, put myself into a place where I jumped directly into an entrepreneurship. So I wanted to start my career by getting into a company as a junior animator, as a person who began his career. And that's how I started, and it gave me a lot of exposure. It helped me learn how a company runs, how a boss has to react, how a leader has to react, how a team lead has to react, how animation works, how animation pipeline works. So to gain knowledge about all this, to know how this animation industry or a digital media industry works, you need to be in that place, as an employee, as a junior animator, or as a junior VFX artist, or as an assistant director. You have to be in that place, and that's the part that I chose. And the people that I worked with, the team leaders that I have worked with, were the main source of inspiration to give me confidence of starting my own company. So, motivation and inspiration can be from anywhere. It's just that, you need to have a true inspiration and a true cause for what you're doing. And if you really feel that you want to be an entrepreneur, then you have to go for it. You have to find ways which are genuine enough to go and achieve your dreams. So, I would say there is nothing called as complexity or challenge until and unless you're in good hands, and until and unless you have a vision, you have a goal, and you have a purpose in this industry. Because I'm pretty sure that any company or any field you get into, it teaches you. Be it you're in a good company or you're in a bad company, it's all about experiencing, and it's all about learning. And I definitely faced challenges, but I would say all of them were positive, because I was a part of companies where I had to work overtime. I had to work on extra hours to achieve that output. But at the end of the day, it was all an experience. It was all things that I took back, and which are helping me today to deal with my employees, to deal with my team. So, there are nothing major challenges. I think it's all about how you deal with them. Challenges will be there in every step of your career. I think it's all about how you can make them positive, how you can make them self-motivating and push yourself to face the challenges. there is nothing called as, you know, specific rules and specific challenges in this field. You can get any kind of challenges at any point of your career. It's all about fixing your mind, having a focus on your career, and just moving forward. The industry that we are in today is booming. You know, it's one of the best industries. It's one of the, you know, futuristic industries, and it's something that, you know, students like you should look forward to. And you know, you have a great future if you can just focus, and if you can have a dream, and if you can have a vision, you can just grow in this industry. Because you know, since we deal with digital content, we deal with videos, we deal with designs, and we deal with all this kind of, you know, content that is interrelated to marketing. And you know, we create content to sell a product, we create content to entertain people. So, you know, entertaining people and selling products never has an end. So the field that we are in, the business that we are in, is entirely related to this, and you know, it has no end. It's just about staying unique. And you know, the only thing is, you have to stand out from the other companies. Because while I'm telling that, you know, the industry is booming and you have a great future, there is also great competition. There are a lot of students, you know, very creative and very unique and very talented students who are coming out every year from colleges and schools, and you know, and simultaneously a lot of companies are, you know, moving ahead and, you know, coming out and, you know, coming up with this great content and great work. So, you know, there is always competition, but there's always future, and there is always space for you to explore and grow in this field. So you just have to take care of the uniqueness and creativity in you, and there is no looking back. You just keep moving forward. You know, there are a lot of factors that influence a business, the business decisions that one has to make. But I think the base factors that you know, that you need to consider always is having a very good team. You know, a very good core team that is very skilled, that is very enthusiastic, that is very talented, and they have a vision for the company, not for individuals. You know, and as a team lead, you have to always make sure that your team is happy. You're giving the right environment. You're giving the right you know, place for your employees to work. You know, you have to always make sure that your employees are growing. It's not just the company is growing, but the employees are also growing. You know, these are some of the main things that, you know, help your employees have a better understanding, better connectivity with your company and yourself. So it's very important to keep your core team, you know, happy and in a very good environment. And it's about the understanding between the, you know, the management team and the creative team. And you know, it's always about discussing ideas. It's always about learning from each other. And it's very important to create that learning environment with your employees, and always be open for ideas. You know, you have to always be open for ideas from your employees, and make sure that, you know, you welcome each kind of an idea. Maybe it might work or it might not work, but giving a space of sharing one's ideas is very important for a business growth. So, you know, these are some of the major factors, I would say, you know, that influence a business decision, and you know, that influence a business growth, or you know, a business position in this market. I would not advise you, but I would just share, you know, the things that I have faced as an entrepreneur, or the journey I had from an employee to an entrepreneur, which I say will help you to quite an extent. Apart from which, I feel it's all about exploring, and I would say that, you know, never, as I said before, never jump into entrepreneurship. Because it's not as you think. You know, it's not just taking up a responsibility and, you know, and you have everything running. It's not as simple as that. So I would say that, you know, if you have a vision of an entrepreneurship, if you have a vision of creating your own company, of building something of your own, then first start from the foundation. You know, first get into a company as an employee, as a junior, learn the ethics of the company, learn how a company runs, learn how a team lead runs, learn how the management runs. Because, you know, running a company is not just about your creativity. You know, you might do the best creative or the unique work, but it's not just that. You know, it's not just about creating a work, it's about selling a work. So when you have a vision of building a company, you need to have both you know, both the tendency of creating a work and selling a work. So, you know, I would say the best thing is to get into a company, have hands-on experience, and, you know, learn about the management, learn about the accounting side, learn about the creative side, learn about the marketing side, learn how to deal with clients, learn how to, you know, be good to your clients, which is a very important thing. And once you start feeling that, okay, you know, I can handle this thing, you know, I know how to deal with clients, I know how to get clients, I know how to deal with my team, I know how to build a core team, when you start feeling confident about these things, only then, you know, so, you know, get into the shoes of an entrepreneurship. Animotion is pretty young now, and it's just been a year since we have started Animotion, and since then, you know, we have been seeing positive side of the company, and we have been working hard. The main reason for this is my team. Now, I have a very strong team who believe in their own growth and the company's growth. They are putting their 100% in it. So I see my company in a very, very good position in the near future, because we have already started reaching out to very good clients. Some of the clients to name are, you know, Tata Central Mall, Future Group, Wonderla, and lot of other corporate companies. So, you know, things have been going really well by far, and it's not just about the company's growth. You know, I have been seeing that, you know, as an individual, be it me, be it my employees, be it my team, you know, we all have been growing personally. So, you know, it's a very positive thing to see that the company is growing along with its team, which is a very, very good sign. And I see a very positive side for Animotion, and I see that, you know, Animotion will be a very strong animation studio, a video production studio for this country, because that's what we are looking for. We are looking for a team, we are looking for a company which can provide world-class work for all our media related industries here in India. So we believe and we are very sure about achieving that in the coming years. Animotion offers a wide range of services. Usually when you look up to studios outside, they either offer live action or animation or VFX, but Animotion is looking out to offer services which are very wide. We are trying to hit all the four categories, that is live action, animation, VFX and designing, so that our clients get to have a one-stop solution for all of their requirements. In live action, we are into event videos, promo videos, we are into TVCs and a lot more. And talking about animation, it's one of the most strong side of our company, and we are both into 2D and 3D. We have not yet touched the classical animation side of it, but we are getting also into stop motion, and it's very important for a company like us to have a good relationship with the clients, and to make sure that our clients are happy, and make sure that we travel with them for a longer journey, which we are doing for quite an extent. And if you visit our website and check the testimonials, the clients are pretty much happy, and the clients that we have had till now are from huge industries, and they are one of the giants in the market. So it really pushes our limits, and helps us self-motivate to move forward and get more client relationships. And I think it's very important to have a good client relationship, and I feel we will try to get more and more of these client relationships in the near future. Talking about the technical side of my journey, I think it's one of the main reasons that has carved me into what I am today. And I would say the technical side of my journey has been a little unique, because I did not constrain myself to just one software or just one technical element, because I always was interested in filmmaking, animation and a lot of other things. So as a person behind the camera and as a person behind all the technical side of this entire thing, it was very important for me to explore a lot of softwares, a lot of tools to make myself apt for being able to execute a lot of variation of work. And that was one of the main reasons which I started exploring different kinds of software, be it 2D, 3D or VFX. I started exploring multiple softwares and multiple tools which helped me learn more about how industry level works are being executed. And it's really important to build your technical side, because without which it's very difficult to sustain in this field. Milestones in my career, I would say, the moment that I got to work as a VFX supervisor for a feature film was one of the best experiences and one of the best learning experiences for me. And not just that, and the travel I had as a freelancer was also a very big milestone in my career. And that is the time when I built a lot of client base, and I met a lot of new people, new opportunities to work. And I would say these two were one of the major milestones in my career which helped me be more confident about what I'm doing. Since this is a technical field, there are challenges in every step of your career, and the industry is growing, there are new softwares coming in, new tools coming in, new kind of work is coming up. So there's always challenge in every step of your career, and you have to deal with it. You have to learn how to learn and cope up with this industry. So similarly, when I used to work in companies, there used to be new softwares introduced, and there used to be new kind of work. And there used to be issues in rigging, sometimes there used to be issues in animation, or sometimes there used to be issues in shoot. So you have to always be ready to face these challenges and try to figure out a way, and try to learn, or try to find a way out of all this. So challenges are a part of our industry, and the major challenges I have faced is an entirely new kind of work. When you're a fresher and you go into an industry, and you suddenly get a work that is entirely new. So you have to be ready to learn, accept the fact that you don't know, to deal with it, so that your seniors will teach you, or you go out and you try to figure out a way and try to solve that issue. So be open, be a learner, and try to accept the fact that fine, I'm ready to learn. So this is the kind of behavior which you need to carry forward when you get into a company, and it will definitely help you face the challenges and come out of it. Animation, visual effects and gaming are something that's booming in India, and India has become a hub. People from outside countries, from foreign countries are coming here to get their work done. Big studios from foreign are getting their work outsourced in India, and a lot of studios in India are getting an opportunity to work for bigger brands outside, and there are a lot of skilled people here in India. So the future for this particular industry is huge. You have a big future, you have a big opportunity, you have a mind-blowing option to work on huge projects, which no other industry can promise you. This industry promises you. The only thing is you have to have focus, and you have to just try to build your skills to be able to cope up to the industries that are looking forward to get work from you. So be confident about the industry and the work that you're in, and you will have a great future. O-Reel is something that's going to speak out your work, because no matter how good interview you give, no matter how good your CV is, doesn't matter. It's all about the showreel. It's all about the work that you carry. So make sure that you have a very good showreel. So by good, what I mean is make sure you try to show your skills out. If you're good at animation, try to have a big research on it. Try to look a lot of showreels as a reference. Try to look showreels that have been produced by big companies, big individuals, big seniors in your particular field, and try to figure out ways that that will make your showreel unique, that will make your showreel speak out your work. So it's very important to have a very good showreel, because that's the first image that's going to be created as to how good you are with your work. So make sure it's not just a basic level showreel, and it's not just a repeated template as anybody else has. Just have it as unique as possible and let your showreel speak out your work. It was great sharing my experience, a part of my journey with you all, and it's great that Veda University is coming up with these kind of initiatives where people like us get to share with young students like you, because you are going to be the future, and you can come out and create wonders, because you are going to carry forward this this animation industry or the visual effects industry forward, and I'm sure that India is going to be a huge platform for all these kind of works, and I would like to wish all the best to all of the students from Veda University, and make sure to explore your talent and make sure to follow your dreams, and don't ever let behind your passion just because of your work. It's important to earn money, but at the same time it's important to follow your passion and be true to your passion. So thank you once again for giving me this opportunity.